Oh, this is Jason from Longtail Laser. Today's video is all about our 3-in-1 laser welding machine. So this is the condition when the machine arrives at your factory. And we've already taken the wooden box off. So next, we will start off by unwrapping the plastic package. So we will have our tech, Mr. Chu, help you go every step by details. So first, we're going to take off the unwrap the plastic package. This is the automatic wire feeder, and when I open this up, give a close-up video. So here is the Henle water cooler, and the upper part is our 2 kW max laser source. Now please give this view a close-up. Look at it, check it right here. So when you open this up, there are a whole box of the parts. This is the nozzles. We will open it later, and this is the protective lens. All right. These two are the protective lens, and this whole box. There are 7 nozzles inside of the box. Actually, there should be 8 nozzles, and the one lost is already on the laser head. This the laser welding head. Now we're gonna show you some preparation works you need to do before starting the machine. So we will have Mr. Chu show you the first step, adding water into the water cooler right here. Now he is adding water into the water cooler. Please make sure that the water you are using is clean water. Here is the gauge, shows how much water you are adding into the water cooler. So make sure the indicator, when the indicator stays during the green area, that's the proper area. So that means the water you are adding to the water cooler is okay. After adding water into the water cooler, the step 2 is power connect. Take off the case first. Here's the wire. The red color wire goes into this place. And the blue color wire goes into here. So make sure the last wire, the yellow one, put into here. Alright, this is how the wire connected. The yellow wire goes right here, the blue wire goes here, and the yellow one, the last one, goes right here. So this end of the wire need to be connected with your factory power. So after you finish all the power connecting, remember to put this case back on the machine. As you can see, here are two sets of the wires attached on the back case. So this one is the ground wire. Make sure that when you work on the pieces, here's the clamp. Make sure the clamp, you need to clamp onto the table you work onto it, or directly clamp on the pieces you are working on it. And this one is the wire feeder controller wire. We will show you later. So now we're gonna open this up and show you how to do with this wire, the ground wire. Now already opened. So here is the clamp. This is the safety. This is the safety device. When you're gonna welding on this table, so make sure you're gonna clamp this right here, or directly clamp on the material. All right. And this one, he is unwrapping, is a wire feeder controller wire, which we will show you later. Here are the two sets of the wire. Okay, the next step is the gas connecting. So we can apply, for the welding, we can apply two gas. One is argon and the next one is nitrogen. So this time we use nitrogen. But just make sure, no matter it's nitrogen or argon, set the air pressure at 1 ampere. So the next step is we gonna turn on the machine. The first, we gonna turn on the factory power. Here it is. And then next we gonna switch on the power of this machine. So here is a switch on the back of the machine case. So turn it on right here. Next, we gonna switch on or twist on the red button right here to open the system control. And the next step, make sure we're gonna check the water in the water cooler again. So because the first time when you turn on the water cooler or turn on the machine, so some water we just poured into the water cooler gonna flow some of it into the hoses because the hoses are empty. So we will notice that the indicator before is during the green area, now it's lower to the red area. That means you need to add more water into the water cooler. Take the gap off and add more water from here. The final step and the most important step is we're gonna turn on the max laser. So here is the red button. Move it forward, first step, and then right here. Here's the max laser source. After like 3 or 5 seconds, push this button.
When the color turned red, that means all ready. Now we can step into the cutting, the welding process.
Now we're moving into how to work on the system. So this is the whole panel, you may say, when you turn on the system control. So here we can see there are two modes on the welding mode right here. The one is continuity, and we tap on it, and which changed into the spot welding, which we also call it the fish skin welding in China. So we turn back to the continuity welding, which I will show you later how to work on this continuity welding. And then the next two is tap on the technology. And as we can see, here are the list of the parameters you're gonna change to fit your welding requirement. The first is scan speed, next is scan width, and this, the third one is peak power, and the fourth one is duty cycle, and the last one is the frequency. Normally, we just need to adjust the first three. So for scan speed, there's no fixed parameters. So normally we set from 400 to 600. So this time we set 400. And for scan width, if you go with the automatic wire feeder, normally we set is 2.8 to 3. But this time we're gonna do without the automatic wire feeder. So normally if you do without the wire feeder, we set from 1.2. to 2. This time we set the 1.2, and later we will do the welding on this 1 millimeter stainless steel right here. So refers to the operation menu. See, and due to the thickness of the material is 1 millimeter, so we set the power around 500. So the last two, the duty cycle and the frequency, you can use at the default. And then tap on the save. Technology one, and then tap on the save. Return. And then we can start welding. Now we are going to do some the welding demonstration show to you. But before that, always remember that you put or fasten your clamp on your working table. And then, so the hose right here from the machine to the welding head is 10 meters, which is long enough for your welding convenience. All right. And then for your safety, make sure your worker put on the safety glasses or the goggles. And then we will start welding. The welding material is 1 millimeter stainless steel. All right, so we just finished the continuity welding demonstration. Now we're gonna change to the spot welding, which is the fish skin welding in China. So tap right here, welding mode. So we tap this one. So give a close up view. So here shows the spot welding. And then when you turn on spot welding, tap on the setting button and punch in the password 123456. Tap it OK. So now we went into the setting parameters. There are only two parameters you need to change for the spot welding. The one is right here, spot welding duration, and the next one is spot welding interval. So make sure this one, we change it to the 150 for the spot welding duration parameters, 150. And the second one, spot welding interval, we need to change to the 50. And all the other parameters we can use as the default. And after do it, tap on save and then return. Now we are ready for the spot welding process. So for the spot welding mode, we need to use the automatic wire feeder. So we will have our tech to unwrap the wire feeder. Now take the wire feeder out from the box all the parts are inside of the box, so you need to take them out. Here is all the parts for the wire feeder. So the black one is the power connection wire. So our tech will first hook up the machine. So right here on the ground, the orange one is the wire feeder hose. So actually there are two ends. So this one have a mount right here, will goes with the laser, the welding head, which I will show you later. And this one will go inside of the wire feeder box, which I will show you later as well. All right. This end, This end will go inside of the box and fasten it up. Now we're gonna put this end or mount this end on the laser welding head. But before that, notice here is a small plastic bag. These are the tools from the plastic bag. Give this view a close-up view. So here are four small nozzles, so which is 0.8, 1.0, 1.2, and 1.5. So you choose one of them according to your wire, different wire. Here is the head. And I took this up and mount this into the head. Yep. And fasten it, twist and then fasten it. After you fasten it, take out the nozzle you choose and mount it on. But we need to do this after we put the wire inside the hose, and then we can do it. So now first take them off and lay them aside, and then next we need to put the wire inside the hose. Now we're gonna show you how to mount on the wire reel. Wire feeding system is on. Tap this button and the wire will automatic come through the hose, and it will come out from the hose head later. Hold your finger on this button until the wire come out from the hose head. So when the wire come out from the hose head, take the small nozzle and mount it on. Now it's ready. For doing the spot welding demonstration, we need to put on the professional welding head. So here is the professional welding nozzle. So you will notice here is the bump with a thin slot in the bump. So this is the when the wire goes through the slot. So we need to take this off and put this on. Just twist the nozzle off. Very easy. And twist backwards to mount on the nozzle. Now it's ready. Now we need to mount on the wire end, this part, onto the welding head here. We need to take the screw off and put them inside, stuck right here, and then fasten it up. And then fasten it. So make sure that the wire goes directly through the middle of the slot right here, and then we're ready. Now we're gonna show you the spot welding demonstration with the wire. This is how the spot welding seam looks like. Please check it out. After the welding section is over, now we come to our cutting section. So back to the original screen, we need to tap on the technology. There's only one parameter you need to change, is the scan width. So we change the scan width from 3, no matter which number, to 0. And then the peak power, we can set at a higher power. For example, we set at the 1500 power. And then tap on import. You will find when you set the scan width to 0, and the scan speed will change to 0 automatically. And then import, save, and then return. That's all you need to do before cutting, and then we will step into the cutting section. So change from welding to cutting, we need to take this part off. Take this part off, and then we need to put on the professional cutting nozzle, which is this one. So probably you will notice this one's color is a little bit different than the others. This one is a little bit more yellowish. So we take this up and took the welding nozzle off. Took this one off and put on the professional cutting nozzle. Very simple, just put it on. And that's all set. For the cutting section, we can only do very simple cutting on the 3-in-1 laser welding machine. And you can only cut it off, you cannot make holes on it. So if we need to cut it off, we need to start from the very beginning right here and then cut all the way down to the end. When the cutting demonstration is over, now we're gonna move into our professional cleaning section. So before we do that, we need to change the system to the professional cleaning system. So here is the button, tap right here, and shows that right here. And then we tap on continue, power off, and then twist it, restart the system. And when we restart the system, and now we, as you can see, we already move into the laser cleaning system. Okay.
As you can see, this is the panel table. All the parameters listed right down this way. So the first is the scanning frequency, and the second is scan width. Next is peak power, and the fourth is duty cycle, and the last is frequency. All the setting parameters, we can use it as the default. Just please please notice that the second one, the scan width, the most scan width can go up to 20, and say we set it here at 20. And then just check the parameters, we can use it as default, and then we will step into our cleaning section. We're gonna use the rusted carbon steel board for doing the cleaning demonstration. From the cutting to the cleaning, very simple. We just need to loosen it and took this part off. And now we are ready for cleaning. Alright guys, here are all the three demonstration videos for the welding, cutting, and cleaning. We already did all the demonstration for you. But before we wrap up, here is one more very important section that we still need to show you. It's how to change the protective lens. Alright, this is all for today's video. So let's wrap it up and see you the next time. If you still have any more questions, directly contact ourselves or ask the question from the email. We will reply you as soon as possible. That's it. Bye.